Hi everyone, my name is Ehsan and in this video I'm going to show you when I'm in a job search mode, how do I manage my files and the jobs that I applied for, how do I keep track of all of these, and this is the behind the scene, the process that I'm going through. And this is not the best, but this is what I do. I know there are some applications that they can make these processes much easier, but you have to pay them, there is a subscription, and I want to have a full control of what I'm doing. So this is my simple process. And before going through all these files and explaining all of that, you might get the idea here and then adjust it to your own, make it your own, and add the things that you think you have to add, but remove the steps that you feel is redundant and it's not needed. So now let's dive into this. So I'm using a simple Excel file. So here in the first tab, I have three groups of jobs. The first one is the one that I'm the right fit for it based on my skills and experience. And then the second group is the one that I can stretch myself. I know my skills and I know I can go into those types of companies. And group C is everything else, every business, everything that I want to start. Maybe one day I want to start a coaching company or a cookie company, a daycare, everything, even tutoring or Uber driver, everything, a cash flow or experience that I have and I can share it and get money in exchange of sharing those values. So everything else comes to this group C. But group A for me right now is the semiconductor companies, and group B is the chemical, bio, and pharma companies. But this might change. When I graduated from University of Florida, I had more experience in the pharma and chemical companies because my degree was synthetic organic chemist. And right now I have 5 years of experience in the semiconductor company. So these two might flip depending on your experience, whether you graduated from your PhD program or master program or bachelor, and now you want to go to the same kind of field and the skills that you have, or you want to change the trajectory and go to another space. For me, it was a different experience. So I went to a semiconductor space, and that's my core fit right now. And the second core would be the chemical space. But if it was like 5 years ago, this could be the other way around. My core would be the pharma, and the semiconductor would be the one that I'm stretching and I want to use my skills to go into that space. But the whole idea is to have two types of groups. One is it's the core fit, the one that you have the hard skills for, and the other one is the one that you know you can do it and you have the skills or you can learn it. So that would be the second group. For me, when I got laid off, I started with group A, and in the background, I also spent some time thinking about group C. What type of experience I can share in exchange of money? What value I can create to get money for it? So I was thinking about some sort of business or coaching or anything that I can do to bring that cash flow. And my strategy was to do that for a few months and then switch to group B if I was not successful finding any job in this group A. So I wanted to focus on this group A. I copy-pasted them all into another sheet. Now, this is the place that I navigate and update and keep track of all the jobs that I'm applying for. This is very simple, but I'm gonna explain it anyway. I have one column for the companies. This is the connector. This is the person that connects me to someone inside the company. And if you recall from my first video, I said if I want to apply for a job, I need to find someone within that company that I called it John. That's my referral. And if anyone else can connect me to this person, I'm gonna call that connector in this column over here. So it might be someone that I know or someone that referred me for another job, but that person knows someone else in another company. For instance, over here, this person is working in this company, Lamb Research, but also I ask her if she knows everyone else in these list of companies that I'm interested. And of course, she knew someone in this company and referred me to that person. And of course, these names and emails are not real for obvious reasons. And I wanted to show you how do I manage all of these and keep track of the jobs that I'm applying for. So this column was the connector, the person that connects me to someone inside the other company. And this one is someone within the company that refers me for that position. This one is the name of the position that I'm applying for. This is the job ID, the location, and the when I applied for that job and the link to that job. So this is very simple and obvious. Now, let me explain how do I fill each row. Let's say for this company, I found the job, I know the position and the job ID. I have to write my resume to customize for this job position. That's the first step. And then I need to find someone to refer me. So I need to find for that person or any sort of connector that can connect me to this person. While I'm doing that, I'm gonna write their names over here. So let's say I reached out to this person on LinkedIn and this is the date and I couldn't get any response back within 24 hours. This might change. If I'm in a hurry, I have to find a job, I am in a rush, then I will do that. But if I haven't graduated and I'm looking for a job and I have time, then I might give it a little bit more of the time. Maybe I'm gonna wait for 2 to 3 days and then I'm gonna reach out to someone else. But in this case, if I'm in a hurry, I'm gonna wait for 24 hours. If I couldn't get any response back, I'm gonna reach out to someone else. And then if in this case, you will see I have reached out to 3 people and I couldn't get anything back. So last one is a referral, someone who works in this company and could refer me to someone else within this Thermo Fisher Scientific. And this is how I keep track of all of this. So this person gave me the email address and I reached out and I got the referral and then I applied for it. So I just come back and update all of these columns. And do not expect that everyone that you reached out will help you. And do not expect everyone that you reached out to reply to your message. This is normal. People are busy, people having their own priorities, and you are looking for a job. It's not their priority. It's yours, but not theirs. So just respect that. And when you reached out, even though they do not reply to you back, it's fine. Just move on to the next person. You need one connection to get you to one job, and you need only one job, right? And you know your values. So over time, when you are looking and doing all of that, just keep that in mind that you need one connection, one offer, and one job. So in this case, for instance, let's say I reached out to this person, there was no reply, and the second and the third, and this one got back to me, let's say, very late while I reached out to someone else that could refer me to this person, and I got an okay. And later on, this person reached out to me and said, yes, I can do a referral, but it was already late. I had already a referral and I thanked this person, said, yeah, I reached out to someone else and I have the referral and I don't need it at the moment. So just, you know, have that in the back of your mind that this is normal, that people are reaching out to you late or even not replying to you at all. And as you can see, this is a pretty simple job tracking system. And over here, I have some color codes for the jobs that I applied, the job that ghosted, I couldn't get anything back, the one I rejected or they rejected me, the one that I got interviews, the on-site visit, or the job offered. And when I apply for a job, I just use that color. I use this brush and then just brush it and make it the same color as the color codes that I have here. And that's how I can keep track of these jobs. The last thing is I'm gonna show you the files. So for each company that I apply for, I have one folder. And as you can see over here, I have 4 resumes. So these resumes are the golden resumes. Inside of each, there are many, many bullet points, and I'm not gonna use all of them. But over time, when I apply for one job, I learn something that I can update, or I remember something that I can add to my bullet points. So I keep track of these resumes and make them better and better over time. But I'm not going to use all of those bullet points when I apply for a job. What I do, let's say now I'm going to go to this folder. I applied for this position. Each position has one folder, and I'm going to use that resume that I had, and I customize it towards this job. Then let's say I'm going to apply for another job and I learn something that I can add to my bullet points. Then I go back, I make a new version, and now this version has all those bullet points and everything. For the next job that I'm applying, I'm going to use this version 4 because it has more bullet points and more things related to the semiconductor space. So over time, this living document will get better and better, and I can use that for my next job. So over time, it's like a feedback loop that I give to my resume and make it better. So if I go back to this folder and this position that I applied for, now I have 5 files. So this one is the cover letter, and this is the resume, and these are the PDF files that I attached and upload for applying for the job, and there is one note file. So what is that? This is the job description, a simple copy paste from the website here. And why I'm doing this is because when the position gets filled or they get enough applications, they will remove it from their website. And I do not recall what they put there. I don't know the salary expectations and every detail about that job. And I'm not applying for that one single job. I'm applying for many, many, and I can't keep track of all of that. So what I do, I just do a simple copy paste, not even formatting them, and I paste it to a new text file and have it here. If I got the interview, I can go back and open this and zoom in and see what type of skills they need and what kind of questions they might ask me during the interview. So this is why I keep a copy of the job description here, just in case they removed it. And this has happened to me many, many times. They will remove it from their website and you don't recall what they had. I'm going to put this job search Excel file as well as a Google Sheet document, and you can use it and keep track of the jobs that you are applying for. But here in this video, I just wanted to show you the process and how do I keep track and organize all my files. That was it. See you in the next video.